which was like a puzzlement to me since I was a little kid, and that was when they say, Jesus freed the world from sin. What does that mean? He freed the world from sin. You know? And I never really got it. The world from sin. I'm still sinning. I mean, I can sin some more. I can sin all I want. I can do anything I want. Boobies. Jesus freed me. I can do that. No. I think what happened eventually was I was in a moment of despair, no doubt. You know, questioning everything. I do that from time to time. A little tumultuous in my head, and a little war, and a little adversaries that fight it out. And one day it occurred to me that the adversaries in my head were the only thing keeping me from peace. And I started to let them go one by one, unconsciously, as they entered my head, went, is this real? Do I even know this person? Sometimes you don't. You don't know your adversaries. Never met them. You create these wars. And I started to let them go, and I suddenly realized what that statement meant, at least what it means for me, is that he freed the world from sin from his perspective. You know, it's up to each one of us to free the world from sin from our point of view. And with that comes freedom. And you got to keep doing it, because they keep entering. But that was a really wonderful kind of transcendent moment for me. And it keeps me in a place where, you know, there's not a gigantic army of people building up at any one time. I can let them go as they come. And life is a lot more fun this way. What else? I mean, I don't want to be presumptuous, but the meaning of life? You want to know what it is? Love yourself. That's all I know, guys. Love yourself. And be visible. It's wonderful this night because it really gives us all a chance to kind of get real for a second and share our true selves with each other, and that's what we're doing. We're being visible tonight, and it's a risky thing. Sometimes it's not considered cool to be out there and to be open. Fuck. I want to be seen while I live here. I want to be seen, I want to get to that place, and you can do all the rest of it anyway. I really think, I was talking to Eric backstage, and I said, you know, I've had this thought about your teachings. You often talk about not having the answers, and Buddha not having the answers, but pointing to the answers. And I realized just recently, you know, what I do, and what comedians do a lot, is they point away from the answers, the opposite direction of the answers. They behave incorrectly. And in doing so, they become the contrast to what you really want, you know? And so I'm really happy with that role. I'll be the contrast for you guys. I'm good with that. So it's a lot of fun. It really is a lot of fun. But I don't want to be up here too long. I have another show to do down the street. The sunrise service is starting soon, and Eckhart and I have to head over there and do it. So, you know, thank you so much for coming tonight and today and through this whole conference. I hope you were as inspired as I was, and gosh, you know what? Again, I don't want to put myself in a place of a Jesus-like type person, but I think what I really want to say about this transcendent consciousness and entertainment is better described in a parable. A young man opens a health food restaurant. And he wants to give people the most pure ingredients, everything natural, nothing bad for them at all. And people come in, some of them like it, some of them don't, but they all leave healthier than when they came in. Then a woman opens up a health food restaurant across the street. But she adds chocolate pie made with agave to the menu. And she pulls all that business over across the street. And he goes out of business. And the moral of the story is, do not trust women. Okay? Do not trust them. It's just that a little bit of sweetness and take it all away from it. No, no, no. That's not the moral of the story. What I'm trying to say... What I'm trying to say is that this kind of entertainment doesn't have to be a bore, you know? And I think if we can, you know, if you want to get your consciousness and your spiritual ideas and things into something, you know, make it taste good, if you can, you know? Make it entertaining, and more people will come. So that's my two cents. I want to try to make it as entertaining as possible, and I wish you all the best with everything you're doing, and, you know, believe in miracles, because they happen, because I'm proof, and I love you all. Thank you very much.
Jim Carrey.